Hello, everybody. Andrea Twarowski here with Dentalelle Tutoring, and happy holidays. We are about a week before Christmas. Oh my goodness, time goes by so fast. But I just would like to hop on and say happy holidays and Merry Christmas. It is the new year soon, you guys. It is fast approaching. But let's talk about how to be organized in the year 2018 and how to be sort of the best student that you can possibly be and just how to make your lives easier, okay? Honestly, remember, I was a student once too. It was tough. It was hard. I hated it. If you've seen some of my other videos, I talk about pretty much crying every day because I was away from home. I had teachers who didn't like me. I just felt, oh my goodness, it was just awful. But I got through it. And the nice thing is that you all have me. Okay, you have me. So if you have questions, if you need help, if you need, you know, somebody to talk to, please just let me know. But the best thing, you know, the best thing, honestly, that you can do for 2018 is to think positive, okay? Think positive. Try not to think negative. Like, you know, try not to think how many classes you were unsuccessful in last term. Don't think, oh, well, I pretty much failed that test last time, or I barely passed last time, so I'm going to do horrible. Or, you know, well, that teacher doesn't like me, so I'm going to do awful. Try not to think about any of that. Take anything negative and turn it into a positive, because 2018 is something new, right? Start fresh, okay? Think about what didn't work for you last year. You know, if you were unsuccessful on tests, think why. Is it because you studied too much, or you probably didn't study enough? If you're studying a day or two before your exam, you probably won't do as well as if you study 2 weeks before. And that's what I always say. Study 2 weeks before a test or exam if you can help it. I know sometimes you have a week's notice, so it's kind of hard to study 2 weeks before if you don't know you have a test coming. But, you know, study as soon as you hear, pretty much hear that you have a test coming up. So then that way you are studying a little bit every single day and not like 6 hours every single day, 2 days before the test, right? Studying an hour or two a day is perfect per topic, okay? Yes, as a student, you do not have much of a life. That's normal. I'm sorry, but that happens. You have to pass, okay? And if you need help, let me know because I can help you guys. Tutoring is an excellent investment because it will make you less stressed. You'll be able to sleep at night. You'll be able to pass, and you will look awesome because you will know things that your other classmates may be like, how did she know that? Or how is she doing so well? I can help you guys, okay? So that does help too. If you need help, if you need a tutor, 2018 is the time to get one. It is worth it. It is worth the investment. I have never heard, never, one single person say to me, oh, you know what? I had tutoring, but it didn't help me. Like, that was a waste of money. Never. And I'm being honest, knock on wood. Everybody says that was awesome. You know, you have helped me so much. I wish when I was a student, I had a tutor too, but it was just too expensive. But I make it very affordable because I want to help you guys. Okay. So think 2018. Think positive. Think about what didn't quite work last year and then make it work this year. If you have to be more organized, buy a planner and write down all of your tests, assignments, projects, all of that. But also take some time off too. On a Saturday evening, say, okay, I am not going to study at all. That's okay. It is okay to take time off. I know I said to try to study an hour or two at least a day, 6 hours max, but you also need a break too sometimes. That's allowed. Another thing though is when you are trying to study, put everything else away. Cell phone, email, laptop, computer, book, magazine, laundry, food, have nothing, okay? Just study properly and just study. Don't look at anything else because if you have other things with you, you could be studying for 6 hours, but then 2 hours of that, let's just say, you were doing laundry or half an hour of that, but probably more, you were on your cell phone. So you don't actually know how many hours you are studying. So when you are studying, be as focused as possible. 2 hours a day minimum, 6 hours max, but also take a break too. It's okay to take time off and say, okay, I have studied enough. Today, I am doing nothing. That is allowed, okay? It is, especially over the holidays. Don't study over the holidays. Say Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, because Christmas Eve's on a Sunday this year. Don't study. Just take a break. If you have to study, study at nighttime. Let's see. Those are the best pieces of advice I can give you. Just think, 2018 is different and you can switch things around. Tomorrow is a new day. Next year is coming up. So just be as organized, as positive as possible. And I am here if you need me. I'll be uploading a video twice a week at least. So keep on watching. And if there's anything that you guys would like to see, just let me know. Okay, you guys? Thank you so much for watching.